In the previous movie, we used ambient occlusion to improve the realism of our UFO model's shaded look. In this movie, we'll speed up our render by replacing the real-time reflections in the ship's hull with a reflection map file. We'll then use a reflection occlusion map to layer the self-occlusions on top of that. Open the scene UFO reflection occlusion start. Right now, the reflection in our scene is calculated via ray tracing. While this is fine for rendering in Maya, ray tracing is computationally intense and might not always be feasible depending on your platform's limitations. A common solution to this problem is to map an image file to a model's reflection color via an environment shader. Open the hypershade. Right-click the UFO matte shader and select Graph Network. We're going to add an environment shader as a reflection to fake the ray trace reflections we're currently using. Create an environment sphere shader, which effectively projects a 2D texture as a sphere to simulate the reflected environment. We'll assign this shader the Mars Sky Spherical file, which was derived from the Mars sky we're currently using as a backdrop. Connect the environment sphere shader's out color attribute to the UFO mat's reflected color attribute. Now open the render settings and navigate to Turtle's sampling tab. Since we're using an environment map instead of ray tracing, set all the attributes in the ray tracing section to 0. To prove that our reflection is being derived by a file and not from the lighting, go to the environment tab and switch from image-based lighting to none. Render the scene. Notice now that even with the ray tracing and image-based lighting turned off, the Martian sky still appears in the metal. This is because the colors reflected at each point on the ship are simply derived by the scene lights combined with our environment mapping, instead of by the incoming rays. Let's create a directional light with a rotation of 111, 22, and negative 21. A slightly yellow color, and an intensity of 0.5 to simulate a bit of shine from the sun. Now render again. The reflection may be present, but due to the lack of ray tracing, we've lost all the UFO's self-reflection. This is because the environment map has no sense of our model's geometry. It's basically just a color palette layered over the ship. Because of this, we can't get true self-reflections. However, we can fake them using the reflectivity attribute to determine which parts of the ship should and shouldn't reflect the environment. Click the Keep Image button so we can use this render for a reference later. In the hypershade, create a new ILR occlusion sampler shader. This time, rename it to UFO Reflect Occ Mat. Set the type to reflection occlusion and assign it to the ship body group. Render the scene. The result looks very similar to our ambient occlusion shader. In this case, the grayscale values generated by this reflection occlusion shader correspond to areas with high and low amounts of environment reflection instead of brightness. However, reflection is calculated differently than shading, we're primarily concerned with light coming from the reflection angle, also known as the angle of incidence, and not the full 180-degree cone of angles around a point. Additionally, the surface of our UFO is highly reflective, meaning that the occlusions should be very crisp and clear. To simulate this in the attribute editor, adjust the min sample rays to 12, max sample rays to 24, and cone angle to 10. Re-render. Notice we're getting far more pronounced occlusions now. The environmental reflection drops off more dramatically where the geometry blocks the environmental reflection. Now we just need to connect this to our UFO matte shader. Like the ambient occlusion we created in the previous movie, we'll first bake this information into a reflection occlusion map. In the render settings baking section, make sure turtle is set to bake to texture and that bake selected surfaces is turned on in the target section. As before, we'll output a 1024 by 1024 mapping, merged to one map. This time we'll want to save it to our OcMaps folder in a file called bakedro.tga. Also, make sure the model view hardware visualization option is turned off. We won't need to preview this effect. Open the common settings section. Unlike an ambient occlusion, the reflection occlusion is camera dependent, so we'll need to specify camera 1. We also want to turn off orthogonal reflections. If we leave this option on, our occlusion will be baked according to a camera directly above and facing each point. This would lead to incorrect results since reflection occlusion is camera dependent. Now switch the render type to baking. Select the ship body group and render. Just like the ambient occlusion in the previous movie, Maya renders the baked reflection occlusion map instead of the 3D scene. Return to the hypershade and select your UFO matte shader. Assign the new reflection map to the reflectivity attribute. Reassign the UFO matte shader to the UFO's body and arms. Return to the render settings and set the render type back to rendering. Re-render. Our reflection occlusion isn't appearing. If you return to the hypershade and select the link between the file and our UFO matte shader, you can see why. Right now, the file's alpha channel is being used to drive our reflectivity. However, we want to use the actual diffuse color itself. Delete the link. Instead of out alpha, we want to connect the out color of our file to the reflectivity attribute of our shader. However, since reflectivity is a single value attribute and not a vector, we can't plug one straight into the other. Create a luminance node. This will extract the luminosity of our reflection map so Maya recognizes it as monochrome. Connect the out color of our reflection map to the value attribute of the luminance node. Then connect the out value of the luminance node to the reflectivity attribute of our UFO map. Re-render the scene. As you can see, occlusions appear where the self-reflections once were. Although these occlusions are not as detailed as the real-time reflections from before, this minor drop in fidelity is generally acceptable with the increase in performance it brings. because the reflection, ambient occlusion, and reflection occlusion are all encapsulated in their own node networks, you can adjust each of them individually, giving you added control over your scene that you did not have before. For example, you can fake glossiness by pre-blurring your environment map and then increasing the sample rays and cone angle of your UFO Reflect Occ matte shader to blur the occlusions as well. However, remember that unlike our ambient occlusion map, we chose to render our reflection map without orthogonal reflections. Thus, we'll have to bake and apply a new map every time the camera angle changes. This technique is used mainly for speeding up complex renders, and unlike ambient occlusion, is not really as useful in an interactive environment such as a game. These are the kinds of decisions you'll need to make on a case-by-case basis, depending on your own computing power and what your scene is meant for.